This is video 10 on differentiation, where we're going to have a look at how we can differentiate sec, cot and cosec. It's following on from video 9, where we proved how you can differentiate tan and get sec squared. So it's a similar sort of idea. Notice that I've got these results given to you on the formula sheet, but you do need to know how to prove them as well. So notice at the top here, you've got tan kx differentiates to give k sec squared kx. So you've got the chain rule involved in this as well, because you've got a kx inside there. So obviously if you were differentiating that, you'd have to multiply it by the derivative of the inside function, which is k. But you do get given these other results, but in this video, I'm going to show you how we can differentiate sec and get sec x tan x, and so on. So, first of all, let's do sec first of all. Let's do sec as 1 over cos. Now we're going to do the quotient rule. So let's let u equal 1, v equals cos x. So, u dashed, when I differentiate 1, I get 0. When I differentiate cos, I get a minus sine. So using the quotient rule, u dashed v minus v dashed u over v squared. So u dash is 0. So 0 times anything is going to be 0. Then I've got minus v dash is minus sine x, multiplied by u, which is 1. That's all over v, which is cos x squared. So we've got the minus minus, so all we're left with on here on the top is sine x over cos squared x. This, however, I could write, if I wanted to, I could write this as being sine x over cos x multiplied by 1 over cos x. Hopefully you can see this is the same as this. It just means that I can rewrite the sine over cos as being tan x, the 1 over cos as being sec x, and this is a bit nicer to write than this, even though they're the same thing. So there we go, we've proved that the derivative of sec x is sec x tan x. And we can do exactly the same thing for the other functions. So cosec, if I write that as 1 over sine, if I let u be 1 and v be sine x, then I'm going to get u dashed would be 0. V dash, when I differentiate sine, I get cos. So using the quotient rule, u dashed v minus v dash u over v squared. So 0 times anything is going to be 0, minus cos x times 1, all over v squared. So on the top we've got minus cos, on the bottom we've got sine squared, and just like we did a moment ago, I could rewrite this as minus cos x over sine x multiplied by 1 over sine x, which is the same thing as minus cot times cosec. And again, this is a bit easier to write than this. So again, we've proved that sec differentiates to give sec x tan x, we've proved that cosec differentiates to give minus cosec x cot x, and I'm not going to do it in this video, but you can do it yourself. If you want to prove that cot x differentiates to give minus cosec squared, just write cot as being cos over sine, and then do the quotient rule to differentiate it.